Gopi, can you please give me your training account? I think this is the one, right?
Yeah, I don't know, the other one. That is the developer one.
Yeah. Okay, so what are we going to learn in the reports? We learn about the different types of the reports, the format of the reports. We will learn how to navigate and the reports tab and how to find the suitable reports. We'll also try to learn to modify the existing reports that we have in Salesforce, and also we will create new reports. We will learn about the filter logics, how do we put the filters in reports. Then we will learn putting the custom formulae, conditional highlighting is there, adding charts and pictures to your report, then scheduling your report, emailing them, printing them. And then tomorrow we will learn about the dashboards, how to add these reports to dashboards. So why do we need the reports? Do we have anyone has any idea about it? Why do we need reports?
A lot actually
No?
to see what data we have, I mean for
Okay.
operational purposes, day-to-day activity, to track day-to-day activity, how much data was entered, what people are doing, and also to
Actually,
do some.
a report, yeah, it gives you an opportunity to analyze your data, right? You can see in this screenshot the two reports, tabular report and the summary report. So tabular report gives you the rows and columns, as the name suggests, table, a report in a table form. Tabular report just gives you the things in rows and columns. But in summary reports, you also see the grand total. You can group by any item in summary reports. For example, here they have grouped it by stage of the opportunity. In summary report, they have grouped this report by stage of the opportunity. And also for every stage, they have the total. For every opportunity, they have total, and they have at the bottom they have the grand total. So summary reports also allow you to find the grand total. Okay, this may be a question in your exam, that where can you calculate the grand total, in tabular or in summary? Where can you group the report by any of the fields in any of the Salesforce fields? So that will be summary report. The other question can be, how do you grant the access to reports? So the access to the reports is given through the folders. So if I go to the reports tab here, these are the folders, right? Sales reports, opportunity reports. So these all are folders at the left hand side. Next to it, where you see a pin, if you click on it, let me see this. I want to create a report folder where I will share the reports with entire team. So I will create a report folder by clicking like this, right? Okay. I will give them the read and write access. This is the access level that I can grant them. Read only or read write access. Right? So which report I am going to operate on? So I am going to play with the opportunity reports. I will add this. See, here is the access level. This folder is accessible by all the users. This folder is hidden by all users. This folder is accessible by only by the following users. Right? I will say all the users. So whosoever can log in and click on the reports tab, they will have access to all these reports. Whatever reports are there under the opportunity reports that we just created. Got it? Later on, if you want to edit the access level, you can also edit it. So this is how you grant the access to your reports to others. Any question about this, the report sharing?
No, it's fine.
In other views, if you go to one of your orgs, maybe in the new org, you have, if you click on the pin next to it, maybe I should show it to you right now. If I log out from this one and log into Gopi's other account, Gopi, give me the access code.
Yeah, you can just see in chat. I already sent you.
Okay. You already sent me?
Yeah. It in chat box.
Okay, let me see. It's the password, it's not the access. I'm asking about the activation code. Check your mailbox. Just give me one moment.
Okay.
Yeah, so are you ready with the activation code, Gopi?
Yeah, 90367.
90367.
Seven, yeah.
So if I go to reports here, so you can see there is a option to share it directly. This is the enhanced view. So if I click on share here, I can share the report folder with users, roles and subordinates. Right, and public groups. Also, if I say users, it will give me the option to whom I want this folder to be shared. once I click on share, then I can grant them the level of access. So viewer is the read, editor is the read and write, manager is someone who can do everything to the report. Okay, but this was the standard report folder, so only viewer action is available. So I just wanted to show it to you. If you see this thing, so don't be confused. So this is something you see it in the new orgs. Got it? Okay, so when okay, so these are, as there are few already built in reports, so they are the standard ones. Okay, you can edit them, override them, right? Like you can edit them if needed, you can edit them, but the thing is the access can only be the viewer access for them. For the standard reports you cannot completely modify them, but you can to a some extent you can edit them. Custom reports you can build in, you can build them from the scratch. You can edit the standard reports and create your custom reports. You can store them in a folder that you have created, and as per your wish you can give them the access level. Anyone you can grant them the access level for that. So there is an exercise. Alison Wheeler, VP of Global Sales, has requested a report showing all of her sales team's opportunities by rep. So Alison Wheeler wants a report where the opportunity is going to be shown by rep, right? So opportunity is assigned to individuals in the team. So she wants to see it by rep and that have been won this year. So all those opportunity, the criteria is the opportunity which they have been able to win and also the opportunities by rep, they want to see it. So first of all they are asking to create a global sales reports folder, then run the standard opportunity pipeline report, modify the report to meet the requirement using the report options. Right, so let's go to the reports. They are asking first to create a new report folder. Global sales reports. We are going to deal with the opportunities in this report folder. Global sales reports. And I will click on save. Then they are asking to modify the existing report. So which report they are asking? to modify. They are asking to run the standard opportunity pipeline report. So this is the opportunity pipeline report which we are going to run, and then click customize.
Should we follow you, so or
I'm sorry,
should we follow you and do the exercise, or
after this I'll not be doing this activity. I'll ask you guys to do it. So but just look at this one. Okay, actually you also need to create it. Okay, so they are asking to create the report where they have won the opportunities. So see, there is a filter at the top, all opportunities, and the opportunity status should be closed one, right? Select the closed date anytime, all time, so that you will have some opportunities here. So they want to see the opportunities by rep, opportunity owner. Right now this is in the summary format. So it's here, it's saying drop a field here to create a grouping. So I will again group it by the opportunity owner. I will drag and drop opportunity owner here. So Gopi has two records, Gopi has two opportunities that he has won. Let's see, I will say created all time so that we will have more records. Let me see, actually I want to see more, we have been able to create the report but we are seeing just two records. I want more records so that our report will look okay. So just two reports, you have just two reports here at the, so opportunity owner is Gopi, so this is, he is the opportunity, so he they were asking to show the opportunity by rep. So who is the representative? Gopi is the representative who has two opportunities and they have won it, they have won it. So we will save this report as close business this year. Let me see if there is something else. They are asking the range to be current financial year, close one opportunity status, that is fine. If we select the current financial year, again we have this two records, not more than that. Okay, there are also few other fields that you don't want to see them, like if you don't want to see the age in your opportunity, so just move them back, the fields. Next step, okay, once you are done with this, click on save and give it a name as close business this year. and save it in the global sales reports folder. Click save and run. So this is the report that you have just created. It is showing the name of the opportunity owner and the stage is close one to opportunity. If you have been able to follow it, go ahead and create it in your org. Upinder, create this opportunity, the report in your org. So first of all, create a folder, global sales report folder.
Yep. Public access, read write or read or?
Give them the read access, all the users.
Okay.
Monica, are you following?
What about public reports?
I'm sorry?
No, no, unified, unfiled.
Okay, so add the opportunities, sample reports, opportunities.
Okay. And then this folder accessible by all users, this folder is okay, all accessible by all users. Click save. And global reports. Global sales reports, okay. And what next? Sample report of opportunities.
If you're done with the folder, then run the opportunity report, which is a standard report folder. And under the standard report folder, you will see opportunity pipeline report. Click on that report.
Opportunity pipeline report.
Yeah.
I just say number of opportunities.
You just see. What do you see there?
Sample report of opportunities.
No, no, you are under the global sales report folder right now. I want you to go to the
opportunity report.
Yeah. In the opportunity report folder.
Report. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay,
run that.
Mm-hmm.
Click on customize.
Customize, yes. Yes.
Okay, now in the filter at the top you see opportunity, select the opportunity, filter all time and the stage, close one.
Okay. What is the difference between closed and closed one?
Closed means any status, maybe you lost it. Right?
Okay.
Any opportunity, maybe you have lost it, right?
Okay.
Done that. So select the time, all time.
Time.
Created, opportunity created, time, all time. The current financial year, you can also try. Current financial year will be the best thing because we are dealing with the opportunity here. So how many records do you see?
Two records,
okay. Now, so right now you just see the stage, right? Right now you see your opportunities grouped by stage, right? Yes, no?
Yes.
Okay. Now, drag and drop the field below the opportunity where you see, do you see it? Drag and drop a field to create another grouping, you see in the reports?
Yes.
So drag and drop the opportunity owner field there.
Opportunity owner.
Your report should look like this. Stage and then opportunity owner.
Opportunity name.
Opportunity owner.
It should be opportunity owner information, opportunity owner. From the opportunity owner, right?
Yeah.
Yep, got it, yeah.
Okay, click on save at the corner left at the top. And save it under the global sales report folder that you have created.
Report global sales report. What name should I give?
Closed business this year.
Closed
business this year.
Okay.
Click on save and run report. Done.
No, no. In the time you said we need to select all time, right?
All time or current financial year? You are just getting two records, so
current
it's fine.
Financial year.
Current FY.
When I say current FY, I'm not getting any records, which is weird. Based on close date. Is it close date or?
Created date.
Created date. Okay, yeah. Created date. I have it. Okay. Run report, yeah, have it.
Okay, the interface that you see where you are modifying the reports, that is the report builder, where you drag and drop the drag the fields from the pane that you see at the left hand side, right? Then you create groupings, review up to 50 records. So that is the report builder. Let's learn about the report formats. The first format is tabular report. So in tabular report, you see that you have just the rows and the columns. You see your data in the rows and the columns, but you don't see the grand totals. Okay. In summary report, you can create groupings and you have the subtotal, and at the end you can also see the grand total in summary reports. When somebody asks you to create a report, then you have to, you know, look for the answer of this question. What sort of report you should create? Are they asking to create any grouping, right? Are they asking just the just to create just to, they just want a table of records, or they want any grouping? So if they are asking for the grouping, you will go for the summary reports. A scope is something you will see, the time period, for which time period do they want the reports. Columns is the field available. So you can drag them out from the field pane, or you can remove them from the report, the columns. Groupings is there, formatting is the summary, tabular, matrix, filters, then you can add the filters, additional filters if they want. Then you can add charts. We have another exercise here. It's asking to create a new opportunity report using the steps on the next slide to help you plan. Set the scope of the report using the standard filters. Change the columns as required. Select the format and grouping. Add a summary field. Save the report. So here, Alison Wheeler, VP of Global Sales, would like a report showing all opportunities which are open. Opportunity stage is open. All the opportunities organized by sales rep. So this is a summary report. Look at this. They are asking group it by sales rep with the opportunity amount subtotal for each rep. So opportunity amount should be subtotal. So they also want the want it to be grouped by, summarized by opportunity amount. Is it clear? This scenario? Gopi, Upendra, Monica? Look at the scenario, let me know if you have any concern before we go ahead. Guys.
Yes.
Okay. If yes, then click on the reports tab. Gopi, you are there? Okay, so click on the reports tab at the top. And here you see the new report option, right? Okay. New report option, and then select the opportunities. New report, then you have opportunities. Select opportunity and click create. So everyone is on this page. Everyone is on this page. Yes, no?
Yeah. I'm just doing that. Give a minute. Okay, new report. Okay.
New report, then select opportunities.
Okay, fine. Yeah.
Expand the opportunities and okay, select yeah. opportunities, and then click create. Upendra, are you done?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I am in the report. I'm trying to add the sales rep group.
Okay.
Okay, Upendra, don't do these steps further because there are a few other things that you need to do here. See, in the filter they are asking to set the opportunity status to open.
Yeah, that I did that.
Range is all time.
Yeah. Because I'm just going against the question and then trying to do it without the steps.
Okay, the next step is, yeah, that is fine.
Organized by sales rep with the opportunity amount, so we group by sales rep, okay. And then we need to have the
grand total. Other people will be confused, Upendra, okay? That is why I'm asking you to just follow this. If you have already done it, it's fine, okay?
No. So now, I'm just trying to understand.
Now the next step is to remove all these fields, type, lead source, next step, fiscal period, age, created date, owner role, from your report, and remove them out into the field pane. So hold the control key on your keyboard and select all these fields. And move them back like this. Got it?
Can I go back to the fields?
Gopi, I'm not creating it for you, so you need to follow this.
Yeah, I'm doing it.
So move them back into the field pane.
Age, created date, and then what else? What all? What is the step B? Click on one of the selected columns headers and then drag the section into fields pane. What is fields pane? Where is it?
That is what I was trying to show you, right? This is the fill pane at the left hand side where you see all the fields, right? You just drag and drop the fields like this. If you want
oh,
to
that
remove
one,
them,
no, that I got it. Okay.
Yeah, then
the steps are confusing. Okay. That's for removing, right?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Hold on, control and click column headers, opportunity owner and record frame. Opportunity owner and on name. Stage duration.
Done? Any confusion about any step?
I am done up to 4th B.
Okay, so you just do need to do it only. You also need to understand.
Yeah,
any
I'm getting it.
Yeah. So anyone, any if having any confusion about any of these steps, do let me know.
After the step 5, we need to click the save, right?
So you have summarized it?
I have done with it.
Mm-hmm. Have you clicked on sum? Select the sum checkbox.
Yeah, done with it.
Okay. After the step 5, just report the run and save as. Right? Save it by opportunities by rep.
Okay, fine.
When I'm saving here, I see save hierarchy level. What exactly that means?
Hierarchy level is Where do you see that when you are trying to save it?
Yeah.
What is the option? Can you please read it?
This says save hierarchy level checkbox is there.
Save hierarchy level is when you are saving it, but this is something, see, there are two things. You give the access through the hierarchy to your reports, or you give access through your you give access. So I just showed you another interface where you can share it with the users and the roles and subordinates. In this interface you can save it and give access but through the hierarchy as well. Okay, for example, if you are the rep, you are having access, your manager will also have the access to the same report. But in that interface, when you are saving it and you are allowing users, so you have to define everyone, like individuals, users, roles and subordinates, then only they will have the access. Okay. So done with this one.
This hierarchy will be applied on the opportunity object, right? Like what?
Right.
Opportunity. Fine.
Yeah. Done. Saved. Ran the report. Do we need to validate it? Do you have a picture?
No, not really. You just need to check if it. You can see all the open opportunities and by rep. Also, you can see if they are showing the subtotal or not.
Yeah, it is.
So it's valid. You have validated it. Okay. So you can also group it by the date. On a particular date, if you have been able to close, how many reports were closed on a particular date, right? So you have these options. If you go to group date by, you have option here. If you in the summary reports, you have option group date by. And then you can have day, calendar week, calendar month, right? So it's talking about that. The next slide, we will do some activity on it, so you will have more idea. Then we have the third type of the report. We discuss about the tabular report, summary report. We have the third type that is the matrix report. So matrix report. So what is the difference between the summary report and the matrix report? You can see it, the grand total is at the top. In the summary report, the grand total was only at the bottom, right? So grand total can be in the columns and the rows in both at both the places. In the matrix reports, if you look at the screen, the grand total is given at the bottom as well and next to the opportunities as well, next to the specific opportunities as well. And the grand total which is at the bottom is the total of all the opportunities, but the grand total that you see next to the opportunities, that is for the specific opportunities. This can only be achieved in the matrix reports. Got it? So here we have the another report that we can create. So the report that you have just created, opportunities by rep, you need to modify that one. Okay? And so what is the requirement? First of all, look at the scenario. So Allison Wheeler wants The opportunities by ref report to show opportunities additionally grouped by close date and displayed in a table. She wants the report to be grouped by close date, right? And then grouped by the
calendar
close
month.
Date and displayed in a table. So that is fine, you can do it. Just modify next to the report that you have just created, opportunities by ref, click edit like this in the screenshot, or run the report and click customize. So there are two ways to customize it. If you have run the report, just click on customize on that report.
I just dropped the close date into the drop a field here to create the grouping zone, and
Yeah.
after that I can get into the D step, D like which it says like on the left, the left of the first close date summary. It says like arrow down and do.
No problem. Let me see. So opportunities by rep, right? Is this the report that you created, Gopi?
Yeah.
I don't see anything here, right?
Yeah, that like just now I dropped that. Okay, you have the closed date, right?
Then why will you select the closed date? Just select created date all time.
I'm just following the
or
steps you are showing there.
Current financial year, the opportunities you deal with the current financial year, right?
Okay, fine.
When I say current financial year, I don't see any data.
For the current financial year? And what is the filter that you have
date,
selected?
Created date, okay. Yes, yeah, created. If you select created date, then I see the data.
Fine, okay. I got it now. Like before, I thought like we should see that before.
Okay,
we have the step D, right?
You need to drag and drop the close date here.
Yeah, already dropped it.
Right. Already dropped it.
Yeah.
And then you have the group dates by this option.
Okay, fine.
Right, so they are asking to group date by calendar month. So group it by calendar month.
Okay. Okay.
Got it?
Yeah, I'm done up to there.
Okay, and at the top you have selected summary format. Select the matrix. Got it?
So in here,
Yes.
if I want to see the grand total for each month, how do I do it?
You can see it there, right? For February, everything
No,
there.
no, no. It is giving for like entire all the Feb, March, April, June, right? If I want to see the grand total for month as well, just in case.
If you are grouping it by month, you will see it for the month as well.
Yeah.
Different.
If you are grouping it by month.
No, no, if I want to see this 140,000 whatever in this grand total section for each row, can we do that?
The grand total. So grand total is showing here. You can see it.
No, no, if you see for every month, you are seeing the data in the rows from the column, right? At the same time, if you want to see it at the row level, can we do that?
For every month, you can see the subtotal. You cannot see the grand
yeah,
total.
Yeah, yeah.
No,
no,
that
for
is the subtotal.
for subtotal, if you want to see the subtotal in the in this area here, can we do that?
See. Yeah, it's already showing. For February, they are showing this one, right? The sum of the amount.
Oh, it's on the top. Okay, okay, got
right?
it, got it.
That is why they have grouped it by month. Okay, so this is the benefit of the matrix reports. If you follow the next steps,
this is done.
Done with this?
Yes.
We are going for save as, right?
Yeah.
Okay, fine.
Because you are modifying the existing data report.
Yeah.
So I'll go to the topics, the other topics now. Okay. Gopi, are you done?
Just I'm typing the description there.
You don't need the description.
Just like if at all I want to get back.
Okay.
Okay.
That is fine. You can do it.
Like if after a week if I get back to it, I don't know like what it is exactly doing.
If you know the reports, then you will be able to identify it. Okay, that is fine.
Yeah.
You have also the notes and everything.
Yeah. I'm almost done. Yeah, I'm done.
Great. Okay, so you can add also the additional filters. Okay, right at the top you can see few filters are there. In this screenshot you can see there next to the filter there is an option to add additional filters. Add a filter, add logic. Right. So after adding your filters you can also add your logics. Logic is the operation on the filters. and an OR operation, right? And or not operation, the operators you can use to add your logics. You can add up to 20 additional filters in a report. Okay, this is the limitation. Got it? Any question about this? Can I go to the next exercise? If not, in your report here, let's do the exercise and we'll get them. So Connor McCoy would like to see a list of all the customer accounts based in New York, Massachusetts, Pennsylvania and New Jersey that have either a prospect rating of hot or an annual revenue over 8 million. Okay, so he wants to see for all these states the customer accounts, right? So first of all, the question is, my question is, on which object this report is going to be based? Is it on opportunity, Gopi?
Yeah, it's opportunities. Like,
it's not opportunity.
It's accounts.
It's accounts. For, so look at the object. If they are asking clearly, yeah. Okay, first of all, look at the scenario they are asking. Yeah. So all the customer accounts based in New York, all these states that have a prospect rating. So they are talking about filters here.
Yeah.
First filter is all these states. The second filter is the prospect rating. Okay. And the third filter is there is a logic that either the prospect rating should be hot or the annual revenue should be over 8 million.
I got it. It takes even in the so, question you can strike.
So what
for
is the logic? Okay, my question is, what is the logic that you can put here?
Like we created it for the month wise.
Filter one, and
state
two or three. Correct or not?
Open yeah, one is for the state, right?
One is for the state. So filter one is mandate, right?
The other one is revenue.
And the logic, the operator that you can put after one, that is and. So and
okay.
Two and three, two or three, sorry. One and two or three.
Okay.
Got it?
Yeah.
Okay, so let's see how you guys do it. So go to the reports tab, click on new report. Select account and contacts and then accounts and then click create.
scroll down. When I applied the filter, it doesn't show anything, the data, which is weird.
Okay. So all accounts, all time selected?
Okay. Date created fields, you need to say what date field?
Here you will select all accounts, right?
Sorry, and date field, is it created date or?
It's range is all time, created all time.
No, created all time, but date created date all time. Yeah, that's it, yeah.
Don't see anything?
No, I don't see any data. All accounts, all time, create.
Okay, let me see.
Accounts and contacts. Oh, I just said accounts and contacts.
No problem, let me see. Accounts and contacts, accounts.
Mm-hmm. I did that.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, remove the last modified date and whatever the activity. All accounts and then all time. Yeah.
You don't see any data?
No.
How is it
at
possible?
Least I should see New York. Yeah, that's what I am. Let me just remove it. When I say equals to customer, I only see California record.
Okay.
Yeah, we only see California record. See, the customer is only California. We only have one record.
Okay, so you have put some filter, right? Type equals to customer, right?
Mm-hmm. So when you put type equal to customers, we only have California data, if you see here, there, right?
It may happen, it may happen. It may happen, I agree.
Yeah, you can see only the California.
Yeah, now if you apply the other filter, you won't see anything because you don't have California in the filter.
Okay, so let's do one thing. Let's select the type is anything. And let's ignore the type right now because we want some data. But we have to understand how to use the filters here. The main goal of this exercise.
Oh, instead of customer, let's select everything. We'll apply
filter,
but
you can try
everything.
You can try that. Yeah.
And then now we have New York and California. Now we'll select New York, so at least we'll have one record. So now account billing state equals to New York. What else? New Jersey. What other states?
NY, MA,
Massachusetts, Pennsylvania, New Jersey. Okay, and now we have one record at least, and then prospect rating equals to hot. So we're going to add one more filter, prospect rating. Prospect rating. I don't see prospect rating in the list when I say and.
You don't see that?
No, I don't see that in the accounts.
Do you see rating?
Rating
should be there.
No, I don't see rating as well.
Are you sure?
Yeah, sure. You can try if you want. Rating. It's in the account, right?
Yeah.
I don't see rating, no.
Mm-hmm. Let me see.
No, there's a thing recreating on the.
Let's fine. I mean, it's just adding a filter, so let's ignore that.
Not really. Let me find, try to find out first.
Annual revenue greater than 80,000.
Created date.
I'll
okay,
apply.
Entire leads to customer, billing status is prospect rating. What? It's not there. They have given exercises and it's not there. It's not good, right?
How many zeros after 80?
If
Four
I
zeros.
Go to if I go to the accounts, let me see. If I there should be the prospect rating, right? Is it there or not under the accounts? Let me first check.
View objects, view fields.
No, I'm just going to the layout.
Oh, the layout. Layout may not have
rating is there, but it was not added.
Where is the rating? Do you see it?
The rating was there in the layout.
Yeah. Yeah. Then why is it not showing in the accounts?
It's not added to the layout, right?
Yeah.
It's not added to the layout, so we need to update. Okay.
Now if I add the filter,
accounts, view layout, edit layout.
Oh yeah, does this list depend on page layout? Like page layout like is just like what the user is supposed to view, right? Not like
that is right, that is correct. It also depends on the access level.
That is more about like access level and all, but the list you are selecting here is will be giving you the entire list you have under the account.
Yeah, that is right.
Where do you add account in any section?
Account?
The rating?
Maybe rating, first of all, I'm not able to see the rating.
Maybe we need to create some field for account with the pickup list.
No, the rating is there. It was part of the layout, right? Shall I add it to the layout and then see?
No, what I mean to say is like layout is more like what the user is supposed to view, right? Like whoever said like a role
okay,
or...
Do one thing, guys. Leave the rating field right now. You can give it a try later on. Add it or create a custom field and then try to see it there.
No,
or
like
discuss?
It's fine. Like we got the concept of like the adding the filters and all, but that is fine. But why can't we see that rating here? Like I can see it there. Why it doesn't show up?
Yeah, that is
here.
What I'm trying to find out. If I log out, maybe this is a training org. So there are some. There may be something missing. If I go to your regular org, let me see. And if I go to the reports, I add a filter here. And if I try to find the rating is there, right? The rating field is there in your development org. You can see it.
That's fine.
If you add it to the layout, it shows. Otherwise, it is not.
See, I have just added it to the layout, so it may be some access issue, right? So we'll have to investigate it, why we are not able to see it in the training or in your development, or you can see it, it's there, right? You got it?
Upendra, you can yep. see it in the trial org, like which we are using in a regular one.
The trainings, okay, let me just save the report and then reopen it. Where do we need to save the report? Global sales reports or?
No, no, did you get it in the filters, the rating?
No, no, no. Yeah. I added it in the layout. Now I would like to save and reopen the report, so now I'll be able to see it.
No, I don't think so. Layout is nothing like.
Save it
layout
under
is,
the
you are just designing it for some user.
No, 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 yeah, but the, if it is not added in the layout, right, the data may or not be.
No, here I am working on the... Mm-hmm.
Gopi, Upendra, listen to
yeah,
me.
Yeah, fine.
That what I'm saying is, there may be something missing. This is a training or, right? That is why we are not able to see it. I will investigate it and let you know tomorrow, okay? It is there in the development org. Okay, so leave that rating field. I will let you know tomorrow for sure. Okay, now what you need to do is just so you know how to add the logic. Have you added the filter logic?
Yeah, that is fine. We can get it.
Okay, so save it in another folder. North is target account.
Yeah, give me a minute at least. I will save that one.
Okay, the name of the report is North East Target Account, and save it in the Marketing Reports folder.
Save it in the Marketing. I don't see that in the...
You don't see it? Marketing Reports folder?
Maybe when I selected under Global Sales, so it's about the folder, I guess. How do I...
There must be another folder, that is the Marketing Reports folder.
I don't see it. My personal custom reports.
Yeah, even I can't see it. I can see just three. My personal custom reports and filed public reports, global sales.
There is... Actually, there is no marketing folder. Let me see. A report folder is marketing reports, they are asking. But actually, we do not have the marketing reports folder. Okay, so maybe
that's
we
fine.
Are.
We'll save it in my personal custom reports. Doesn't matter.
No, actually, it will matter when you create your dashboards, because the dashboard is completely based on your access level. Okay, so save it under the global sales reports, or maybe create a new folder as marketing reports and save it under there.
Can we
create a folder now? When we are in the report
open,
page.
Open it in the next page.
Okay.
Open it in the next tab and then create the folder.
New report. New folder. Okay, that's fine. Yeah, I'll create.
Marketing reports.
What marketing reports? Read only and
yeah,
unified public records. What about unified public records?
It's the accounts.
Okay. And save?
Yes.
And then save report. I'm still not able to see it. Maybe I need to refresh it.
Yeah.
So how do, can we refresh the screen?
Yeah, you can.
Okay. It is taking to, it messed up. I need to create again.
Yeah, we need to get back, redo everything.
Yeah.
Okay guys, so do one thing, create it later on. Let me discuss the another topic. because we have so many topics to discuss in the reports and the dashboards. I hope you got how to add the filters and the logics, right?
Yeah, that's right.
Yes, no? Okay. So let's create the...
Can I take a screenshot of that page?
Yeah, sure. Gobi, you also take it, okay?
Yeah.
Yeah, this should be good. This should, went too far.
No, just take, this is the scenario. I just wanted you to take it, right? And then
wait a minute.
Sorry, I didn't take the previous one.
You want it?
Can you scroll down? The first page? The scenario?
Yeah. I hope
can you
see it now.
Not yet.
What do you see right now? I am on the scenario.
Okay. Hold on. Okay, I have it next. Next page. Okay. I'm done with this.
Go to next. Okay, that's fine.
Done with this?
Yeah.
Okay, so we have another exercise where we will add the formulae. So where you have the option to drag and drop the fields to the report, there you have another option, that is to add formulae. So we will learn in this exercise how to add formulae to calculate the win rates for the reports that we have created. Win rates is the percentage. So first of all we will need to calculate the average of the win, right? So number of the won opportunities divided by the number of total opportunities multiplied by 100. So that will give us the win percentage, right? So we will learn to add, basically this exercise is to let you know how to add the formula into your reports. So look at the exercise. So she wants a report showing all the company's win rates by sales rep. So we have already created a report where we modified the opportunities by rep. Where we created opportunities by rep, right? So go to that one and add a summary formula to display the win rate. Save the report called as sales rep win rates in the global sales report folder. So first of all, open that one, the opportunities by rep, click customize.
Opportunities by rep. Where is it? It's under
Global Sales Reports folder
global
that we created in the first exercise.
Open.
Click
the
customize.
Click edit. Okay.
Yeah. The opportunity status should be closed.
Okay, that should be closed. Okay, only two records.
Okay, fine, no problem. So in the field pane, double click the add formula. Do you see add formula?
Yeah,
click on that. Now follow the instructions. Open the 2A.
Win rate, description ratio of 1 to closed opportunities. Formula percent, decimal places 2. Where will this formula be displayed? All summary levels, okay. Summary fields,
actually,
or one.
Wrong direction, I think. We need to click edit to the next opportunities by rep, right?
Yeah.
Where is exactly the reports tab he's mentioning there? 1A step.
Summary fields.
Which step, Gopi?
I click, I've been to the opportunities by rep and click the editor next to it. What's the next step?
Opportunity status should be closed.
It shows like all opportunities, my opportunities, right?
That is fine, but the opportunity status should be closed.
Okay. Fine.
Okay, another filter. Now, when you are done with this, in the report section, where you see the data, there is add formula field. So click on add formula in the field pane where you see all the fields. Click add formula. Got it?
Wait a minute. Double click add form. Okay. Oh, I'm actually searching it in filters. I wasted my time. Yeah, fine.
Okay. So follow the next step to create the formula.
When you hide the details, it is only showing just the summary field.
Yeah, it will. It will just show the summary field because you are hiding the details, right?
Yeah.
You got the win rate?
Yeah, okay. Win rate, yeah. Opportunity owner, it just
what
says.
What is the percentage?
100%.
Okay.
Is that good or?
Yeah, it's fine because sometimes when you have any issue with the formula, you see error. Instead of the win rates, it displays error message. That is why I just wanted to confirm it.
No, I think it's good. It's basically you're doing some formula and adding it to the report. It's simple. The GUI is a little weird, but.
Yeah.
SQL.
You find it weird?
Yeah, I mean, I'm used to better reporting tools. So.
Which reporting tool?
I used Tableau, Cognos, and other specific reporting tools.
So, what are you working as? I mean, where are you working nowadays?
Me, I work for Quest Diagnostics. Actually,
Agnostics. Okay, so
diagnostics. It's a healthcare industry.
Okay. As a,
I'm an enterprise architect actually, for
Okay.
analytics and BI.
Okay.
So I deal with enterprise data and analytics and enterprise information management. So I build data warehouses and stuff for enterprise.
Gopi, so you have a good exposure to the reporting tool and everything, right?
Oh.
For me, not much.
Yeah. Okay, no problem. No problem. You will get to know about. So Salesforce is, I already said to you guys, this is on boom, and it will really give you a good exposure, and you will also be able. If you, I mean, somebody is not having a good job, if you do this certification nowadays, you're going to get a good job. I am sure. And
So
it's everywhere.
for
It's the
401
jobs.
certification, I mean, do we have any documentation where we can read, and is it tough to get the certification with what we learned so far?
Okay, actually, after learning all these, I will also give you some questions.
Okay.
Okay. And the percentage is 67%. Are you done with this report, Gopi?
Yeah, what?
Are you done with this report, my first question?
Yeah, I'm working on 2B. Show details to hide details, something like that.
Yeah.
2B. Okay. Yeah, okay, that is fine. So, I was just saying, the passing marks is 67%. I'll give you questions. So from my side, you will get at least 40%. The exact questions. Okay, 40% the exact questions. The 30% that you need to do it on your own, based on whatever you have read and understood so far.
Okay.
So you should be able to clear it. This is my understanding.
Okay.
Right. There shouldn't be. It's not so tough. You have 90 minutes and you have almost 60 questions, right? So you have to just make sure that you don't, I mean, leave all the questions. You already know how to handle the exams. Whatever the questions you don't know, leave them first. Try to, attempt the questions that you are sure about and put them in review. The other, just do not confirm them, and then you will be able to clear it.
I think once we know what type of questions they ask, and then probably we can go in that direction and read, and then prepare.
Yes,
so
that is why I will give you the questions.
I think that should do it.
I will not say that you will get the exact questions. Whatever I'll give you, you may get it, but from my side, I cannot say that you will get the exact questions. Right?
That's true.
Okay, guys, so this is all for today. Let's meet tomorrow. Okay.
Yeah, thank you.
We will do some more reports and learn about the dashboards as well. Okay?
Okay.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Bye.